Now, I know what you're thinking, arrays? Seriously? But hold on, because arrays can actually be pretty useful and interesting once you get to know them. So, what is an array? Well, it's a data structure that stores a collection of items, typically in a contiguous block of memory. That means all items in an array have the same data type and they're stored in a specific order, kind of like a shelf in your closet where you keep all your socks organized by color. That's totally normal, right? In Python, arrays are not a built-in data type, but we can use the NumPy library to work with them. Let's see how to create an array in Python using NumPy. First, we need to install NumPy if we don't already have it. Once we have NumPy installed, we can import it into our Python script. Now we're ready to create our first array. To do this, we use the array function from NumPy, which takes a list of values as its arguments. For example, here we create an array of integers from 1 to 5. Easy peasy. Now we have an array of integers that we can use for all sorts of fun and interesting things. But wait, what if we want to create an array of floating point numbers instead? Well, no problem. We can specify the data type of the array when we create it using the dtype argument. Now we have an array of floating point numbers that we can use to do all sorts of scientific calculations and stuff like finding the average temperature on Mars or something. Anyway, once we've created an array, we can access its elements using the index. In Python, like many other programming languages, the index of an array starts at 0. So to access the first element of an array, we use the index 0, the second element has index 1, and so on. What if we want to modify the elements of an array? Well, no problem, we could do that too. We can modify the elements of an array by assigning a new value to a specific index. Voila, we have a shiny new value here at index 2. But arrays are not just good for storing and modifying individual values. We can also perform operations on the entire array. So, for example, we can add two arrays together element-wise using the plus operator. It's like magic, we just added two arrays together and we got a new array as a result. We can also use other operators to perform subtraction, multiplication, and division element-wise on arrays. In addition to these basic operations, NumPy has provided many other useful functions for working with arrays, such as finding the minimum and maximum values, sorting the elements, and a bunch of other stuff. So first, let's see how to find the minimum and maximum values in an array. And to do this, we can use the min and max functions from NumPy. So for example, to find the minimum and maximum values of an array of integers, we can do this. Now, we know the range of values in our array, but what if we want to sort the elements of an array in ascending or descending order? No problem. We can use the sort function from NumPy, like here, to sort the elements of an array of integers into ascending order. And if we want to sort the elements in descending order instead, we can use the flip function after sorting the array in ascending order. As you can see, sorting arrays in Python is a piece of cake, but wait, there's more. NumPy also provides many other useful functions for working with arrays, such as calculating the mean, median, and standard deviation of the elements, as well as performing matrix operations. So first, let's see how to calculate the mean and median of an array. To do this, we can use the mean and median functions from NumPy, like here, to calculate the mean and median of an array of integers. The mean and median of this array are both equal to 3.0. It's like the array is average in every way, but what if we want to calculate the standard deviation of the elements in the array? To do this, we can use the std function from NumPy. The standard deviation tells us how much the values in the array deviate from the mean. In this case, the standard deviation is 1.414 something something something, which means that the values in the array are relatively close to the mean of 3. But arrays in Python are not just good for storing and manipulating individual values. We can also use them to perform matrix operations, such as matrix multiplication and transposition. Let's have a look how to do this. So first, let's see how to perform matrix multiplication. To do this, we use the dot function from NumPy. For example, to multiply two matrices of floating point numbers, we can do this. As you can see, the result of multiplying these two matrices is a new matrix with the correct values. But what if we want to transpose a matrix? That is to say, to swap its rows and its columns. To do this, we can use the transpose function from NumPy. Arrays in Python are not just for fun and games. They really are a powerful tool for solving real world problems and making our lives just a bit easier. So if you want to impress your friends and your boss and whoever else with your mad Python skills, be sure to master arrays and NumPy. And to learn more about other features of NumPy, you should watch this.